Now, if you've ever wondered what 60s music legends PJ Proby, The Searchers and Gary Peckett and the Union Gap are up to now...
Wonder no more.
Every man knows that as he gets older, he might need to tone down the crazy hairstyles of his youth. Unless, of course, you're a veteran rock and roll star with an image to uphold.
Your audience will always have a picture of you in their minds in your 20s, usually with long flowing locks, maybe even a ponytail. It's a lot to live up to.
This is the 60s Gold Tour. Its stars are from the decade that changed the world, and they have the hair to go with it. The question is, do the icons of the 60s still have what it takes? Now they're in their 70s. First up is one of the stars of the tour, Gary Puckett.
Get out of my mind, my love.
When he had a monster hit with Young Girl, he was a mop-top 25-year-old. Now he's a rather greyer 73.
So, the 60s were obviously known as quite a wild time. I mean,
were a wild time.
It was a wild time, mm-hmm. Was it? How wild was it for a Union Gap?
The word wild always, elicits drugs and, you know, orgies and things. And we weren't really a drug or orgy band as such, you know?
Okay.
And all these years later, he's still the sensible face of the 60s.
Truth is, I love the people and I love the music, but... I also get up in the morning knowing that, I have a family to support and a daughter in medical school and things like that, you know.
How's that? All right?
Great.
Magic.
Well done. You better run, girl. You're
much too young, girl. Waiting backstage is John McNally, singer and guitarist in The Searchers, who topped the UK charts in 1963 and 64.
Everybody's out on the in the 60s, I mean, a lot of people were growing their hair and stuff like that, but you guys never really went that way.
We all had quiffs in those days.
Okay.
But our dress sense was, we liked Cliff and the Shadows, and they liked all that suit business, and we thought, well, we should get suits, you know, black and white, that's it. And that's been our image ever since.
But surely they went a little bit wild.
The first few days until the novelty wore off, and then once you start touring, overnight trips and buses and beds in, it just became smelly and boring.
Okay.
All the lads getting half cut all the time, so it got out of hand, so I didn't enjoy that part of it.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome The Searchers?
How's that?
Very nice, yes, superb. Saves me a few bob.
You happy?
Yes, I am. Sweet,
from a sweet, sugar from a honey. Gary and John have survived the rock and roll years pretty unscathed, but not everyone was as level-headed.
So my next call is with a man who drained the 1960s to its last drop. He's out here in his motorhome. Wish me luck.
When PJ Proby arrived in the UK from Texas in 1964, he was an instant star. People had never seen anything like him, or his ponytail. Today, he is a bequiffed 77-year-old who is still very proud of his barnet.
When did you last have it cut?
Last week.
Only last week?
Yeah, and permed.
You had it permed as well?
Yeah. You know you're
looking so good. PJ had 11 hits in the UK, but is perhaps best remembered for something that happened one night in Croydon in 1965.
My pants split on stage. And Mary Whitehouse, who had this thing called the Morals Committee, went to town on me and had me banned from all theatres.
But now he's back, and so is his ponytail, which today comes in a detachable form.
How old is this? How long have you had this?
That is about 4 or 5 months old.
Oh, really? So it's quite new?
Yeah.
Expensive?
About £3,000.
Whoa. How long can you keep doing this for, do you think?
Forever.
You're happy to go on stage,
I'll dance right into a big old hole in the ground.
How's that? Looking good?
That's fine.
The three men I've met today have a combined age of 225 and are all very different.
But I think the one thing they all have in common, which keeps them looking so youthful, is rock and roll.
Well, Jasper, that was like a trip down memory lane.
Was it?